Hello friends, I'm Dr. Ritula Thakur. I'm Assistant Professor in Electrical Engineering Department of National Institute of Technical Teachers Training and Research. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss Industrial Robotic Arm. Robotics is a very important part of automation. Now firstly, let us understand what is robotics. Robotics is basically an interdisciplinary branch of engineering and sciences that deals with mechanical engineering, electrical engineering and computer science engineering. We can say that it is an amalgamation of the various technologies that deal with use, design, manufacturing and application of the robots. Now what are robots? Robots were basically designed and they are very important part of automation. They were basically designed to reduce the human effort. Okay. Now we have with us one of my MD student, Mr. Anurag Chaudhary. He will be giving you a brief description about a robo analyzer, which is basically an industrial robotic arm. Over to you, Anurag.
Thank you, ma'am, for giving a brief introduction about robotics. Hello, everyone. I am Anurag Chaudhary, MA student, Electrical Department, NITER, Chandigarh. In this lecture, I will discuss about industrial robotics arm. So let us start from the basics. What is a robo? Robot is a science of new and modern technology for general and the industrial purpose. There are many types of robot available in the market for different type of applications such as agriculture, industrial purpose, etc. Basically, robots have three basic parts: mechanical parts, electrical parts and the programming part. Mechanical part: there are some kind of mechanical construction just like a frame, shape and just usually for a solution of a particular task or problem. In the electrical aspect to controlling and providing the electrical power to the sensors, circuits and controlling motors. In the programming part, there are particular program for controlling the robot, means make it the program to how it control the robot. This is the robotics arm. In this robotics arm, the five stepper motors and one gripper is there to controlling the five axes. Every stepper motor control one axis. There are five axes are there. This is five, 1, 2, 3, 4 and the five. This is the gripper. This is the axis control. Axis one, there are five axis control. Two gripper control, one input and one output. This is the gear and chain. Gear is used the very different tasks and reasons, basically to reversing the speed of rotation, to increase and decrease the speed of the motor and to shift one axis controlling to the another axis. Suppose if you want to control this axis by the gear chain, we also control this axis. So that's why we use the gear and chain. So it is the robotic arm, and now we are go for the robotic trainer. This is our robotic trainer. So this is our trainer kit. In this kit, there are some indicators for the different type of axis. There are indicators, axis 1, 2 and there are 5 axis. This is the gripper axis. You can see where gripper is activate or not. Which axis is activate, the indicator will be on. And this is the motor controlling. There are 5 stepper motor. So every stepper motor have a controlling signal. So in this trainer kit, we use a stepper motor driver for controlling the signal and a Cortex microcontroller for making a program. This is a LCD display. What is the position of your axis? It's displayed by this LCD, and this is the input and this is the output. You can need some power from the source, electricity, and then you give to the motor and actuator controlling signal with the stepper motor driver. So this is all about the trainer kit. Now we are go for software, which type of software and which type of programming we use. We also making the some simulation and GUI file in the MATLAB simulation, and I go for that. Now we discuss about the software. First of all, you open your MATLAB, and in where I save the program, just I open that program. This is our program. I make a GUI file to controlling all the axes. It provide controlling angle here, and I also simulate this function
this is our simulation model. In that model, there are 5 axes. 1 axis, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th. And there are grip. In my manual, I make a data sheet for that. You can also focus on this. Basically, we providing, suppose we are doing the axis 1, the range of axis 1 is 0 to 300. The second axis is 0 to 90. Third axis is 0 to 90. Fourth axis is 0 to 300. So this is the limitations of that particular arm. And the gripper is 0 or 1. When you providing the 0, that means your gripper is off. When you providing the 1, that means your gripper will be activated. So this is the coding. And now I show you, the double click on that. When you double click, you providing the angle here. Suppose I want to provide a 45, so it is a 45 degree. So your first axis, your first motor which connected to the axis 1, it rotate 45 degree. Okay, then second axis is you also provide the 45 degree. Okay, so what happens? Your second motor will be rotate at 45 degree. So like that we can show, I also show the demonstration of that particular arm. And the gripper, has you show 0 or 1. When you providing the 0, that means your gripper is off. When you providing the 1, that means your gripper is on. So this is the basic of all about MATLAB. And now I demonstrate you how it control. Suppose you want to control the axis 1. So you are provide, suppose I provide the angle 45, then okay, the robotic arm will be moved. Okay, suppose you want to provide the angle 90 on the first axis, the robotic angle may be providing 90. Means you, it add the 45, because from the 0 it also 45 angle, so it plus the 45 angle another, that it completed the 90 degree angle. Now I go for the axis 2. So my second motor, I will giving the value of suppose 45 degree, so my motor will be moved. You can see the 45 degree, it will be slow. And I will also suppose I want to fix this 0, so it will be come back. So now I make it 45, then go for next axis. So this is my second axis, and now I go for the third axis. This is my third axis. I also giving the angle 45 degree. Suppose you provide the 30 degree, no problem. You can change the angle many times. Just that at 30 degree angle, your arm will be moved. At 4, you provide the 45, yes, some other, you provide the 40. Now, motion will be moved. Now the gripper are there when it's on 0 or 1. You can provide 1, the gripper will be on, and when we is go to 0, the gripper will be off. Now I also show you continuous run, all how it control continuously. First of all, I make it 0 because what is the initial position. So for achieving the initial position, put 0 to achieving its initial position. Its initial position, like you put all the 0. All the axes coming in the 0. Now 2 axes are remaining. Put 0 here. Now the next one is 0. Now this is your initial position. Now I show you how it automatically. You can control manually or automatically. There are two methods. You can control easily, no problem. When you are providing the automatic, I'm making a program to pick and place some object. So this is my GUI file, and it is also defining, you can define the number of cycle, how much cycle you require, how many times, suppose you have 45 products to move one palace to other, so you can number of cycle define here, you can, I define the two number of cycle, and I just demonstrate, just click start, so now my robotic arm will be moved, just you saw.
take object and place at other display object. And now it come back, the same procedure will be repeated at two times. Because I write the two cycles. First of all, it come in the previous initial condition, then he repeating the whole process. Now we take the objects, step, go forward, leave the objects. Now it come back in initial position. So you can see that how can we control by the manually and automatically. So it's very beneficial to industrial applications, and you can also use the general purpose, which type of teaching and learning applications, learners. So thank you so much for watching this video. He is Mr. Govin, in charge of art and design, and he is Mr. Chandan, editor and camera. And if you like this video, please subscribe my channel, and if you have any query, please put in the comment box. Thank you so much.